tribute to a member of the Concordia community whose trailblazing spirit and next-generation approach in the pursuit of excellence challenges current-day boundaries. This is a very special moment because this award is being presented for the first time this year. It was created, this award was created in honor of John F. Lemieux, who passed away on July 15, 2017. John était un être exceptionnel qui avait le don remarquable d'inspirer ses pairs de la communauté de Concordia pour unir les forces et servir éventuellement le bien commun. A renowned lawyer, John was a deeply committed human rights activist, and he led by example through volunteering and charitable giving. He had a lifelong dedication to his alma mater and served on the Loyola Alumni Association Board of Directors from 2004 to 2014 and served on Concordia's Board of Governors from 2006 to 2014. En 2012, John a également reçu le prix du mérite Humberto Santos. We are honored to have his daughter, as Jennifer Lemieux, with us tonight to present the inaugural award. I'll start with asking Jennifer to come. Our first recipient of this award is Thomas Dowd. Il a obtenu un baccalauréat en commerce de Concordia en 1992 et a été porte-parole de sa promotion. Thomas a travaillé brièvement dans le milieu des affaires, puis a amorcé en 1995 des études pour devenir prêtre. Il a reçu l'ordination en 2001. As a student, Thomas was heavily involved as president of the Commerce and Administration Students Association, as well as student's representative on Concordia's board governor and senate. Il a maintenu ses liens avec Concordia après ses études, en siégeant au conseil d'administration de l'Association des diplômés au début des années 90, puis est revenu, quelques années plus tard, enseigner la théologie. While Thomas chose to leave business for the priesthood, he never really forgot the skills and knowledge he acquired. He brings his entrepreneurial spirit everywhere he goes and has often introduced religious institutions to the same standard of excellence employed in the business world. Utilisateur précoce d'Internet, Thomas est devenu en 2003 le premier prêtre canadien à tenir un blog. So for those who don't understand French, he was basically the first Canadian priest who had a blog in 2003. So, Thomas was consecrated as Auxiliary Bishop of Montreal in 2011, becoming one of the world's youngest bishops. So for his incredible entrepreneurial spirit and creativity, for his next-generation approach to tackling challenges and his deep commitment to innovation, and also for taking a selfie with the Pope, which I saw in his great picture. You should tweet it, actually, so that people see it. We are proud to present Thomas Dowd with the 2018 John F. Lemieux Medal.
I think somebody's been turning some water into wine over there. I remember the day when I fell in love with Concordia. It was actually Valentine's Day, 1989. I was a student at Marianopolis College, and you know, when the various universities would go to different campuses to recruit potential students for their own universities. And there was a member of the Faculty of Commerce and Administration, one of the staff who was there to present the various programs at Concordia. I took a look at the booklet that was there, and I immediately realized this was the program that I wanted to follow. So I filled in the application that day. You might say, I proposed to Concordia on Valentine's Day, 1989. And I got an answer 2 weeks later. I was already accepted, and I just knew that's where I was meant to be. Because honestly, McGill was playing hard to get, so. I think you needed a degree just to fill out their application form, but that's a whole other story. There's an old saying, don't let your studies get in the way of your education. And at Concordia, I quickly became involved in various student organizations, as you heard. My very first thing, actually, I served frozen yogurt at the homecoming events on my first year. But I've learned the power of just showing up. And when people needed someone to fill in on this or that group, pretty soon I was vice president and then treasurer and then president of the Commerce and Administration Student Association, to my own great surprise, because I never actually got elected to those things, I just showed up. And those were wonderful instances of learning skills of leadership. I have to say, I owe Concordia so much for all of the things that I learned. My final year when I was president, I was on, I think, 25 different university committees, including the Board of Governors. That was a great honor. And so with all of those various things, I used to say that class was something I did between meetings of the Student Association. I have literally slept in the office in the GM building at that point. And just to be involved and to get to know so many people and be so enriched by all of those different experiences. Now, of course, I left the business world to go into the priesthood, and so people often say, you know, why did you leave that to go to this? But I always say, you know, a degree in business is a better preparation for the priesthood than you might think. My specialization was in international business and specifically creating teams of people from different cultures. People may all speak English, for example, but it doesn't mean they're speaking the same language. And I found that that was a great preparation for the kind of work I do now. And years later, Cardinal Jean-Claude Turcot, Archbishop at the time, entrusted me with caring for priests coming from many different countries to help integrate them into the life of our church and to serve our broader society. And so the degree I got had a direct application to the work that I was doing. Another thing that has proven to be very effective in church leadership from my time at Concordia is that I did learn how to attend a lot of meetings. I am still looking for the passage, maybe you can help me, you folks are all pretty smart. I'm looking for the passage in the Bible where it says the kingdom of God will be built by attending lots of meetings. It's got to be there because that seems to be what I do most of the time. But honestly, that sense of teamwork, that sense of camaraderie that we had as we were working together. And don't think that involvement in a student association was a small thing. The year I was president, our association had 5,500 members, and we were managing a budget in 1992 of $450,000.
Wow.
So it was like being mayor of a small town, or being bishop of a small diocese, I suppose. And honestly, I owe my vocation to the priesthood in part to my time at Concordia, because I would say that my first experiences of having a leadership role of caring for others came in that moment. Because yeah, there were lots of meetings, but we had a rule that if a student walked in the door and you were prepping for a meeting, you dropped your meeting and you spent time with that one person. And it echoed for me the passage of the Bible where Jesus says, sometimes you have to leave the 99 sheep to go after the one who was lost, to tend to the one who was lost. And very often we would have that, students coming in with all kinds of need, and that opportunity to assist them was really a great blessing. I was honored to, as I say, be on the Board of Governors, and if I have one contribution, if you go through the minutes of the meeting that year, you will see that Concordia didn't have a flag. And so we were doing a special event in our faculty, and I brought it up. I said, why don't we have a flag? Because we need something to wave, because all the other universities have one. Do we still have a flag? I hope we do. Excellent. Okay, so that's my legacy here at Concordia. I was a teacher afterwards, and just very honored and proud to be present. And I would want to add, I'm joined tonight by my mom, who was a graduate of Concordia in 1975, the first year that she took on the world of humanity. When I got the call for this particular award, I remember thinking, okay, what is this about? I was actually picking her up at the airport that day, so while I was waiting in international arrivals, I looked it up on my phone. Presented to a member of the Concordia community whose trailblazing spirit and next-generation approach in the pursuit of excellence challenges current-day boundaries. And the first thing I thought to myself was, what does that mean? But honestly, I have given it much thought, and I found that there's a phrase there that continues to be unpacked. I've actually written that phrase in my spiritual diary that I journal in each evening. And I just thank you for, you may not have known it, but you've actually nourished my relationship with God as much as, you know, my own sense of being honored this evening. And so for that, I'm very, very grateful. And I'm thankful to the two of you and for the legacy that John Lemieux left to our university. And so, my friends, I wish you all a great evening, and thank you so much. I feel very blessed to be with you tonight.